ठीक है, तो हम लोग आते हैं सबसे पहले। आज हम लोग का देखिए मैथ का ये पहला क्लास है। सो इन दिस क्लास फर्स्ट विल स्टार्ट व्हाट इज इक्वेशन एंड व्हाट इज फंक्शन। सो व्हाट इज इक्वेशन, व्हाट इज फंक्शन। सो सी, इक्वेशन लुक्स लाइक दिस। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ आई एम राइटिंग वाई इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस वन, सो दिस इज एन इक्वेशन। बट वॉट इज मीनिंग ऑफ फंक्शन? सी, फंक्शन मीन्स दिस इक्वेशन आई कैन ऑल्सो राइट एज वाई माइनस एक्स इज इक्वल टू वन। आई कैन ऑल्सो राइट एज वाई माइनस एक्स माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो। सो ऑल दीज थ्री आर इक्वेशन। बट वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ फंक्शन? फंक्शन मीन्स इन द फंक्शन यू विल बी हैविंग थ्री थिंग्स। यू विल बी हैविंग टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वेरिएबल। वन वी से एज इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, वन वी से एज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, एंड वन वी से एज कॉन्स्टेंट। नाउ इन कॉन्स्टेंट वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट, बट वी विल नॉट डिस्कस अबाउट दैट। वॉट इज इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, वॉट इज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल? सो आई एम राइटिंग अ फॉर्मूला ए इज इक्वल टू लेंथ इन टू विड्थ। सो ए इज एरिया, एल इज लेंथ, बी इज विड्थ। सो इन योर विड्थ द बी वैल्यू इफ यू चेंज, एरिया विल चेंज ऑटोमेटिकली। इट मीन्स एरिया डिपेंड्स ऑन विड्थ। सो दिस एरिया इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन बी, सो एरिया बिकेम डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एंड योर बी इज इनडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल। बी डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन एरिया, एरिया डिपेंड्स ऑन बी। इन सेम वे इफ यू चेंज एल ऑल्सो एरिया विल चेंज। सो अगेन ए इज योर डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, एल इज योर इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल। सो वॉट इज द पॉइंट हियर? पॉइंट इज योर ए इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन एल एंड बी। सो यू कैन से दैट योर ए इज द फंक्शन ऑफ एल एंड बी। सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन इक्वेशन एंड फंक्शन। दिस इज योर इक्वेशन, बट वेन वी राइट एनीथिंग इन दिस फॉर्मेट, दिस मीन्स इट इज अ फंक्शन। नाउ सी, फंक्शन वी हैव सेवरल टाइप्स ऑफ फंक्शन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई कैन राइट ए इज इक्वल टू साइन एल इन टू साइन बी। सो हियर यू सी साइन फंक्शन इज कमिंग, साइन फंक्शन इज कमिंग, ओके। बट दिस इज नॉट द राइट फॉर्मूला ऑफ एरिया। राइट फॉर्मूला इज दिस। इट मीन्स योर फंक्शन विल गाइड यू टू अचीव राइट इक्वेशन। दिस इक्वेशन इज रॉन्ग, बट दिस इक्वेशन इज करेक्ट। सो यू हैव सेवरल टाइप्स ऑफ फंक्शंस। सो सम बेसिक फंक्शंस यू अंडरस्टैंड। बेसिक फंक्शन मीन्स यू माइट हैव हर्ड देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड साइन, कॉस, टैन, दीज थिंग्स वी कॉल देम एज ट्रिग्नोमेट्री फंक्शंस। Sometimes we have sine inverse, we have cos inverse, we have tan inverse, so they are inverse functions. Or sometimes we say inverse trigonometry functions. We have log. Log is a different function. So to write an equation, there will be some function involved. Means, suppose I am writing a function equation as y is equal to sine x plus cos x. So this is equation in which you have sine function and cos function. Okay, something else can be explained? Yes, types of function. You see, as I said, trigonometry function, inverse trigonometry function, log function. Other than that, we have algebraic function. So several types of functions. For every function, you have their domain and range decided. So these kind of basic concepts we will properly deal in a chapter name called calculus. Okay, what is my duty now? To give you some idea about solution of equation. Some basics I am going to take, solution of equations. Because almost in every chapter, we have the same thing. Find the solution, find the solution, find the solution. This kind of issues will be there. So see, here I am going to teach you what is the meaning of solution of any equation. Okay, suppose I am writing x plus y is equal to 1. A very simple example I am taking. X, y is equal to 1. Now see, in this, this x value you see and the y value you see. If I will substitute here x is equal to 2 and if I substitute here y is equal to 2, then I will not get 1. So 2 and 2, I mean 2 comma 2, is not the solution for this equation. This value 2 you will say as right now it is not the solution. Okay, if I will put x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, then definitely I will be getting 1 as my answer. If I will put x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0, in this case also I am going to achieve 1. If I will put x is equal to 2, y is equal to minus 1, y is equal to minus 1, then also I am going to get 1 here. So I am trying to say whatever value you achieve which will satisfy the equation, these values are only known as solution of the given equation. Now you have a point. Whenever equation is given, will it be having solution? Of course it will be having solution, but how many solution? Like you can see here, one equation, two equation, three equation. Can we solution, can we have some more solutions? Yes, of course we can have some more solutions, but how will you know that how many solutions we have? So this became another concept to understand, how to find out how many solutions we have. Okay, so some more basic detail. This solution itself is known as zeros of the equation. These solutions itself, they are known as zeros. They are also known as roots of the equation, roots, roots of the equation. So in basic 9th class, 8th class, we have we are given with some two equations and they are saying us to find out roots of the equation. Okay, so I will take you to the basic 9th class, 10th class, so that I can teach you the roots and solution for the very basic equation. My intention is just to clear some basic to start gate for the mathematics for the gate exam. Okay, so what is the meaning of solution? So this is the meaning of solution. Guys, are you getting what is the meaning of solution? Very good, very good. Now you see, suppose I am giving you one equation, 2x plus 3y is equal to minus 1, x minus y is equal to 2, and I want to know what is the solution of this equation, of these equations. So here your meaning is different. What is the meaning of this? Actually, whenever you have x power single, I mean 1 and 1, then it is going to be a straight line. So first thing you should be master, whenever any equation is given, how to draw the straight line, how to draw the line. So very, very easy technique. You put x is equal to 0 and you find out y value. So this is the line where you have x coordinate 0. So x is equal to 0, if I am putting in the equation, so I am getting 0 plus 3y is equal to minus 1. So y is equal to minus 1 by 3. So I am getting minus 1 by 3. So I am getting here somewhere minus 1 by 3. So it means what? Just if I am taking this coordinate as my zero minus 1 by 3. Because x value is 0, y value is minus 1 by 3. So from this equation, I got one point. Now, what will I do? I will put y is equal to 0. You put y is equal to 0. So if you will put y is equal to 0, then how will you find out x value? Same. 2x plus 0 is equal to minus 1. So x is equal to minus 1 by 2. So it means what? Where is x equal to minus 1 by 2? This side on the axis. Because this is the line, everywhere you will be having y 0. So suppose this is the point. Just imagine this is the point which is x is equal to minus 1 by 2. So what we have got here? Actually, this is a straight line which is passing through these two points. So this is the straight line which is passing through these two points. So idea is, whatever points will come on this line, like here, whatever points will come on this line, they all will satisfy this line. Now I am using a word, satisfy. What does it mean, satisfy? Satisfy means they all will be roots of the equation. They all will be solution of this equation. Means they all are, suppose there is any unknown point. Just imagine the coordinate is x1, y1. So if you substitute x1 value here and y1 value here, then automatically you will be getting minus 1. Okay, because this line we have drawn according to this equation. So whatever points are there, they all will satisfy this thing. Okay, now you see, I am going to draw line for x minus y is equal to 0. So for that I will just clean my screen little bit. Okay, now you see here. See, actually I am going into very basic. I understand I should not go to this much basic, but because I don't know, you guys are comfortable till here or not, that's why I'm teaching into this much basic. So see now, I have to draw this equation. So how can I draw this equation? Same procedure. You substitute x is equal to 0. So 0 minus y is equal to 2. Then you substitute. So okay, find out y value. Y value is minus 2. Then you find out. Then you put y is equal to 0. So if you are putting y is equal to 0, then you are getting x is equal to 2. So from the first condition, you got the coordinate 0 minus 2. From the second condition, you got coordinate 2, 0. Always remember, x coordinate you should put first, then only y coordinate you should put. So 0 minus 2. Where is your 0 minus 2? 0 minus 2 will be somewhere here. 0 minus 2. And where is 2, 0? Your 2, 0 will be somewhere here. So you join them. I am changing the color to join them. You join them with blue line like this. Now see the beauty here. Beauty is, there is an intersection point. You can see here. This intersection point will be having a coordinate, correct? That coordinate is common for both. That coordinate became the solution of both the equations. That coordinate. Okay. So how will you find out that coordinate? So this is what we have to learn, how to find out the coordinate which is common for both the lines. So there are so many ways to understand this. In sentence wise, we say that solve both the lines. It means you have to find out at how many points they are intersecting each other. Then they can also say how many solutions are possible for these two lines. It means they are targeting this coordinate. They want to know. So how will you approach this? So see, in our basic mathematics, how do we find out this this line? We solve both the equations. So there are so many methods to solve these equations. Now in this gate preparation, in which method you are very comfortable, it depends on that. Popularly, we have three methods, very popularly: elimination method, substitution method, and cross product. Okay, so elimination method means if both the equations are very similar, it's like, let me explain that method first. I'm explaining elimination method. It means we have to eliminate one variable. So it is 2x plus 3y is equal to minus 1. So from this equation, you write second equation, x minus y is equal to 2. In both the equation, here you have 2x, but here you don't have 2x. So you make 2x here. Or another approach is, here you have 3y, search 3y. No, you don't have 3y. So you make 3y. So you choose any one approach. Either you make xx equal or you make yy equal. I am teaching elimination method. Okay. So what to do? Anything we can do. So I am doing one thing. I am multiplying throughout with 2, 2, 2. Because of that, after the multiplication, I got 2x. My equation changed, but I got 2x. So which will help me to solve the equation. Now see, you have got 2x here, you got 2x here. What to do? They both are positive, right? So if you will add the solution by mistake, then this 2x and this 2x will be 4x. You don't add, you subtract, so that xx will get eliminated. That's why the method name is elimination. So what can we do? You just subtract both the equations. Can we subtract? Yes, of course. If you will subtract, what will happen? These two guys will cancel. Actually, in our school level, we used to learn this method by saying this. Change the sign. Minus, plus, minus. This is how we used to change the sign. So this will get canceled. So this will be 3y and 2y. So it will be 5y. And this will be minus 1, minus 4. This will be minus 5. So y coordinate I got as minus 1. So you got y coordinate. If you got the y coordinate, then that's all done. This y coordinate you can substitute either in this equation, you can or substitute in second equation also. Why do you have freedom to substitute in both the equation? Because this y coordinate is coming from both the equation. So it is going to represent this point. And this point is common on both the lines. That's why you are free to substitute this value in first quadrant also and second equation also, first equation also and second equation also. So which equation is look physically easy, that equation you can choose. So I am choosing second equation, x minus y is equal to 2. In this I am substituting, sorry, in this I am finding x is equal to 2 plus y, and then you substitute y value as minus 1. So you got 2 minus 1, you got 1. So x is equal to 1 and y is equal to minus 1 will be your coordinate. So how will you represent this? This point, it means on the x distance 1 and on the y distance minus 1. You got the coordinate, almost done. So this is the solution of both. So here what we have learned, whenever two equations are given and if they are intersecting each other, then how to find out their intersection points. This is basic mathematics. Now suppose there are two more methods, substitution and cross product, that you can learn from anywhere, but that is not important because you need, I hope that you know that those methods also. You need any one method, yeah, you need any one method to crack this. Okay, now you see, yeah, so no need to waste time. Now we'll go and understand, what if your equation is not linear? What I mean here, power one equation was linear because you were getting straight line. But what if your equation is not linear? For that, I am taking one example. Suppose I am taking x-axis and y-axis. Now, suppose I am writing equation y is equal to 3x square. And I am also writing equation x is equal to 2y square. So you can see here your power is not 1, 1. Okay, how will you check the power? You see here 1 is written, here 2 is written. Powers are not same. So definitely it is not going to be line. It is something else. Here also power is not matching. So of course this is also not a line, something else. So that something else we call as parabola. How will you check parabola? In parabola, one power will be 1, another power will be 2. And what is the best way to draw any parabola? Single y will represent axis. Just trick I am talking, trick. Some student may be confused, like I should draw parabola like this or parabola like this or like this or like this. So for them I am giving you amazing trick. So what is the trick? Trick is y is equal to 3x square. You check out y. This is y written here. It means what? Your parabola will cover y axis. Simple trick. Now you go for the second one. This is x written here. So it means what? Your parabola will cover x axis. X axis means this. Okay, now see, if I am giving you any equation, suppose I am giving you 5y square plus 2x is equal to 0. How will you draw this equation? It is very easy. How it is very easy? 5y square is equal to minus 2x. You can rearrange the equation so that it will look like minus x is equal to 5y square by 2. So now your parabola is covering minus x axis. It is only based on the student because I am teaching the trick. So this minus x, so parabola will cover minus x axis. Very simple trick. Guys, are you comfortable with my trick? Very good, very good. So your parabola will be like this. So now see, I am giving two equations. 2y square plus x is equal to 0, and I am giving x square minus y is equal to 0, and we have to draw both the parabolas. So first job is draw both the parabolas, and then remaining talk we will talk later. See, I am drawing the first parabola. So no doubt first you arrange the equation so that it will look like this. So I can send this x this side, right? So it will look like minus x is equal to 2y square. So my parabola is going to cover minus x axis. Okay, so my parabola is going to be like this, and then I'm changing the color. I'm using blue color, and in the second equation you can see x square is equal to y. So my parabola will cover y axis. So y axis will be like this. Okay, y axis, this is my y axis, this is my x axis, this is minus x and this is minus y. Okay, So you can see we are getting two cuts here, one cut here and one cut here. So now these two guys are going to cut at two different places, which means we have to find out two coordinate. Now if you are finding out two coordinate, then definitely you are going to get quadratic equation somehow. Okay, that's all. So quadratic equation, how will you get? Take this x value. After taking this, and suppose you have found out this minus x value as a 2y square, so you can rearrange this as x is equal to minus 2y square. So this minus 2y square substitute here, so it is going to be so I was talking about types of, so I have forgot the equation what I took, because everything I'm teaching from myself, nothing copied from any book. So I'm just taking another example. Suppose it was x square is equal to x square plus y is equal to 1, and just suppose y square 2y square plus x is equal to 0 something. So the first equation, if you will draw, put it 0, other will be difficult. So you can see here minus y is equal to x square, and you can see here your minus x is equal to 2y square. So I will draw this parabola first. So I will change the sign, so it will cover this guy, and this will cover this guy. So here we got two intersections, one here and one here. So I was saying that this time, definitely, when you will be finding out these two coordinates, you are going to get the quadratic equation. What I mean? See, y value is here, right? So this y value substitute here in the equation. So this entire equation will be in terms of x. How? Y value is x square. So sorry, minus y value is x square. So send this minus sign this side. So your y value will be minus x square. This minus x square, you substitute here only for the y. So it is going to be 2 minus x square whole square. I hope you are getting what I am saying. So now your equation will look like this. Minus x is equal to 2. And now you see, after squaring, this minus will be plus. So x power 4. So now you can see, we are getting some different type of numericals now. I mean, our equation became x power 4. If I am not doing any mistake, I hope I'm not doing any mistake, right? That's all. We have to solve these two numericals. So now see, to solve this numerical, what you need? You need to know how to solve bi-quadratic equations. So here only the basic math comes. So it means what? You should know how to solve this kind of formats, ax square plus bx plus c, I mean quadratic equation. You should know how to solve cubic equations. You should know how to solve bi-quadratic equations. So these are the small tricks. So if a student is not comfortable with these kind of equations, they will feel difficulty even though they know the concept in the chapter. Okay, what is my main intention here? My main intention is to explain you what is the meaning of root. Like root is, if you solve both the equations, you are going to get two cuts. Two cuts means one is this common intersection and one is this common intersection. So this coordinate and this coordinate, we say as roots, or we say zeros, or we say solutions. Now, see, what is the beauty of our first chapter? Linear algebra. We have linear algebra. Right now, just in previous case, I took the straight line, right? In case of a straight line, if I am taking, suppose this equation, 2x plus y is equal to 3, and I am taking x minus y is equal to 1. So suppose this is my first equation, this is my second equation. And I want to know whether they are going to intersect, suppose if we don't know if suppose we, if we are not drawing the equation, then maybe a condition is one line will be like this, just imagine, and another line can be like this. Maybe one line is like this, another one can be like this. I mean, I am trying to say that they can be parallel. If they are parallel, then they will never cut each other. And if they will never cut each other, then in mathematics we say that no solution exists. I mean, there is no solution. Why there is no solution? Because they are parallel. And there can be condition that your one line is like this and your another line is just above this, means parallel, but exactly on each other. Exactly on each other and parallel also. So you see, if I have to draw this line and this line, then it is very clear that they are going to cut at a particular point. So they will be having one solution for sure. One solution for sure. One solution we call as unique solution. Okay. And if you have lines like one line is like this, another line is exactly parallel to like this, they will never cut each other. If they will never cut each other, then you will say no solution. Or you say solution does not exist. No solution. But if the lines are exactly, one line is like this, and imagine another line is just over this line, just over this line. In that case, what will you say? You will say that, see now, see the beauty. At every point is lying on line, both the lines. Every point is lying on both the lines. So there are infinite points which will satisfy the equation. So you will say infinite solution. So these three popular names, no solution, unique solution, and infinite solution. Okay, so these are the names we can find out with the help of matrix and determinant concept. So that's why linear algebra we approach. So why do we learn linear algebra? If you know linear algebra concepts like matrix determinants, you can easily find how many solutions are going to exist. So now see the body building blocks. Building blocks are why we learn linear algebra. So here I gave one example why we learn linear algebra. This is just an example. If you want to solve some equations, then you can put them into the matrix, and that matrix will tell you what kind of solution exists for them. And why do we call them as linear algebra? Because we will discuss only linear equations. We will not discuss parabolic equation, circular equation, and this kind of equation. Whenever I will draw any matrix, it will always be look like this kind of format, AX plus BY, or if you are dealing in 3D, then CZ is equal to 0. This kind of equation will come. Guys, are you understanding why do we deal with a chapter called linear algebra? Okay, because we have to find out solutions of given equations. Now see guys, actually, if equation is written like this, X plus 2Y is equal to 1. If equation is written like this, minus x plus 4y is equal to 3. You see the beauty of this equation. And I'm going to write equation like x plus y plus z is equal to 1. X plus 2y plus 3z is equal to 3. Then I need one more equation. Suppose I'm writing 2x plus y plus z by 3 is equal to minus 4. You see, now we got three equation. So in this case, I will draw a different type of matrix. In this case, I will draw a different type of matrix. I may have situation like 2x plus 3y plus z is equal to 1 and x plus y is equal to 2. In this case, I may have different type of matrix. It means what? With the help of matrix and determinant concept, we can find out solution of the equations, but directly you cannot find out. First of all, we should know the operations through which we deal during matrix and determinants. It means first we should know if any matrix is given, then how to deal with the matrix, types of matrix, basics of matrix, addition, subtraction, everything. Because if you know very well about matrix and determinants, then only you can solve these kind of equations. Okay, so when we will start our chapter called linear algebra, in that we have to do all these things. First of all, we will go through the basics. Basics means types of matrix, types of determinants. and then operations. Operations means how to add two matrix, how to multiply two matrix, like these kind of operations. Row shifting, column shifting, these kind of operations. So, but in GATE exam, our approach will be different. How and after that, some more basics like rank of matrix, eigenvalues, eigenvectors. So these things. And after that, we have applications. Once you will be learning these things properly, once you are totally aware about the types and everything, these operations, then only we go for the application. During application, we used to solve equations with the help of matrix. Right? So this is what we are going to start in our linear algebra portion. Okay, now we'll stop today. From next class, we will start linear algebra. And I have to send you some basic formulas. But actually, those basic formulas I will also take during the classes. And whatever difficulty will be coming according to the basics, don't worry for that. In class itself, I will go into proper detail for those basics. So this was the first class for mathematics. Now we'll start our, for XE, we have to start for thermo and SOM, right? So now we'll start our thermo.